take this opportunity to welcome you to our today's sharing. May the Lord bless you as you listen to the Word of God. My name is Elder Peter Mwangi. I love Jesus. He's been good to me, and I praise Him for what He has done and what He is doing in my life. I want to briefly talk about storms in life. As we go through this pandemic, it is a storm. It is something that is disturbing us or distracting us from our normal sequence in life. Normally, I wake up and go to work, and you can pass through seeing a friend. But now, because of this storm, it has disturbed us from our natural way of doing things. So there are things that happen when such disturbances come. And I want to encourage you that even Christ Jesus foresaw these times. And he told even his disciples, let your hearts not be troubled. That is in the book of John, chapter number 14. Let your heart not be troubled. So troubling moments will always be there. We will be facing calamities and disasters in life. But we can be of good cheer because the Bible says, for I have overcome. So even in such a situation, Christ has overcome. So in this storm, I want to tell you that you are more than an overcomer. Now, when we are going through storm, like what we are going through right now, I want to declare to you that the grace of God is ever more sufficient in this storm. That you are not alone in this situation. You are not waiting on the waters alone. The waters shall not overwhelm you because the mighty hand of God is in control and is holding you firm. His grip is ever firm, is more firmer than before. He is not going to let you drown. He's giving you the grace to go through this storm. In the book of John, chapter number 16 and verse 23, the Bible says that in this world you find many troubles, but rejoice, for I have overcome. It means that, my brother, going through this pandemic is not a new scenario to God. It may be new to us. It may be something that we have not faced, but God knew about it from the foundations of the world. So rejoice, for He is giving you the grace to go through it. When you have these difficulties and storms, these things that God is teaching us, I actually call it the Academy of God. He is teaching us, or He is working in us to refine us. You know, in the book of James, chapter number 1, verse 2 and 3, it says that, brethren, brothers and sisters, consider it pure joy whenever you go through trials and temptations of many kinds, because you know the testing of your faith brings perseverance. So here, James is telling us that we should rejoice when we are going through these situations. We should rejoice when we are going through troubles. We should rejoice when we are going through the corona pandemic. Because the testing of our faith, brother and sister, my brother, the testing of your faith is to bring out a better you. God is at work in you. He knows what He wants you to be, and so He is at work in you. He may be stretching you, but you are not yet to the limit. He may be stretching me, but I'm not yet to the limit. He is at work. So the testing of my faith produces perseverance. And if you go ahead with that scripture, it says that perseverance produces a character. So God is molding us to become better people. So rejoice as you go through this. Do not lament. In fact, say, glory be to God that I am going through it, for life shall overcome. Book of 1 Corinthians 4, 16 to 18. It says that though we be passing through these calamities, on the outside we may be wasting away, but on the inside we are being renewed day by day. We are being strengthened day by day. We are being increased in faith day by day. So the inner man is becoming stronger. Through this pandemic, through this storm, the inner man is becoming stronger. The outer man may be wasting away. The outer man may be experiencing difficulties and challenges. But the inner man in me is being modeled day by day. There are some expected results as we go through the storms in life. Number one is that the expected results through this Academy of God, through this school of God, is that once we have graduated from this storm, we shall be a better people. You know, Job said in the book of Job 23 and verse 10 that he knows the way I take. Oh yes, God knows the way I take. And when he has tested me, I will come forth as pure gold. That when I have gone through the testing, as Job was being tested, he knew that God expected him to become a more better person, a more refined character, a more refined product. Pure gold goes through testing. And this trouble and these storms are to make you better and to make you good. They are not to make you bitter. They are not to make you bad. They are not to break you. They are to mold you. Number two is that we go through these storms so that we can also learn to become, you know, a sense of encouragement, so that we can be able to stand and encourage other people. We can be able to go out there and tell other men that God, who took care of us, who has taken us through this storm, he's also going to take you, so that we can become barren numbers, the sons of encouragement. You read in the book of 2 Corinthians 1, 4 and 5. It says, who comforts us in our troubles so that we can comfort those in trouble with the comfort we ourselves have received from God. So, brother and sister, God expects you to be an encourager. He expects you, once you have gone through this storm, to be a source of encouragement to other people. May you be a source of encouragement to others in Jesus' holy name. And the last point I want to make is that when we go through these storms, God wants to reveal or to manifest his power. He wants to glorify himself in it. That's why I'm encouraged and more convinced than ever before that this storm is not to sweep me out of my feet, is not to sweep me away, is not to destroy me. God wants to glorify himself in it. So whatever I become, God will be glorified. He's going to fight for me. He's going to stand with me. So this storm is not for my destruction. This is not what leads to my destruction. It is to build me up and make me better. And all glory, honor shall be to God. I want to encourage you, brother, as you go through the storm you're going through, as you face the challenges you are facing today, they may be diverse, we may not understand, and some we may understand, but let me tell you, God understands you more than us. May the Lord bless you, may the Lord keep you, may the Lord sustain you. In Jesus' holy name, amen.